Hello, hello, and welcome to the channel. Today we are going to do the review of the MiniTool Partition Wizard. If you like the content of the channel, please subscribe. It's free, hit the like button and share. So, let's go. This is the main menu of the MiniTool Partition Wizard. Let's review the different features that the program offers. For example, we have this migrate operating system to another hard drive, SSD or a mechanical hard drive, copy partition, copy disk, very interesting. Partition recovery, wow, very useful. Copy disk, convert global partition to master boot record partition. That is very interesting if you want to increase the size of the partition for the operating system. Wipe disk, imagine that you want to sell your hard drive and you need to completely erase the hard drive before sell the hard drive, and delete all the partition. So let's start with one of the interesting features, that is the copy disk wizard. Click next. From here we have the main disk, and next we can copy the entire disk to another one. So click next. Yes, of course, going to replace all the data on the destination disk. Let's continue. From here, we can make some adjustment of the partition. In this case, I'm going to leave it like this, fit partition to entire disk. Next. All right, very important notice. From GPT disk, you need to enable on the BIOS, change the BIOS to UEFI in order to be able to boot from the new hard drive copy. So click OK and finish. But if you can see the big arrow that appears over there that says okay, you need to apply to start the desired process. Yes, close other application to free up other resources to start the copy operation. It's starting, well, very fast. It's just a matter of time until he finished the copy partition operation. All right, we finished. Click OK and check the result. As you can see, perfect. So it's the disk number 2. Let's open from here. This is the local hard drive. So let's review local C and local H according to this. Cool, perfect. It's the same partition. And we have a perfect copy of the original partition. So basically, if we remove this hard drive and connect it to another computer, fixing the BIOS settings to UEFI, will be working without any problem. So basically, we clone the hard drive. We have three hard drives in this computer, and we have this another partition. Right click, we have a lot of options. Format, delete, label, explore, hide partition, change letter, convert to another partition format like FAT partition, serial number, and so on. But we are going to just delete the partition. And remember, apply to make the changes. So click yes, successfully, so disappear. Right now, partition recovery wizard. Let's go. Next is the disk number 3, 40 gigs. Next. Okay, full disk. Well, if you want to save time, maybe unallocated space or a specific range. But let's run a full disk. Next, quit the scan. Next. It's just a matter to wait until finish to recover the partition that we just deleted a few seconds ago. Wow, 99%, almost done. So let's wait. We finish. Let's check out here on the file explorer. There is no more partitions. The partition that we delete is gone, but we have the opportunity to recover. So after the analysis, this is the partition, 40 gigs, and click on finish. Of course, apply. Yes. And now it's creating or recreating or recovering the partition. So at the end, we are going to get our partition back. So it's just updating the partition information. It's just a matter to wait few minutes or seconds until finish. So partition recovery. So right click. Let's review, for example, explore. Yep, that's it. This is the content of our partition. Click OK. And now it's just matter to assign a dry letter, F. Yeah. Remember, apply. Yes. Successfully. Let's go here. 40x partition. Successful recovery. So let's review the content. Is here. Perfect. Go back. Software. Well, basically that was the content of the partition. One of our favorite feature is this space analyzer. Just run scan over the select hard drive. Just matter to wait, finish the scan. With a quick look, this is the guilty. Almost 14 gigs of hard drive space. The rest have a few, you know, well, almost 4 gigs, almost 2 gigs, and so on. But inside Windows, which folder is taking out all the space? This one, WinSXS. Wow, actually 50% of the hard drive space. Huh, incredible, almost 7 gigs. With, wow, almost 70,000 items. But which folder basically is, you know, taking that amount of space? But, well, according to this, or maybe, let me go until the end. Nope. This is the end here of that folder. And going back. Well, maybe it's the sum of all the items that are using almost 7 gigs. But basically this folder is in all the Windows installations. So yeah, it's taking a lot of hard drive space. Well, with this space analyzer, you can easily check how the hard drive space is consumed. Well, but there is more. We are talking about a disk partition utility that, well, we can do a lot of things like copy the partition, recover the partition, migrate the operating system, a space analyzer that basically most of the time you need another software to do that. But look at this, disk benchmark. So another useful tool that is inside the partition wizard. So let me run this one. This is the partition that we just recovered few minutes ago. Let me start. And now we can do or run this benchmark. This is pretty nice. And we don't need another extra software or extra tool. Already finished. This is interesting because the transfer size was measured with 4K, 8K, 60 and 32K or kilobytes. But in order to understand the results, they prepared this tutorial that is here in the website of partitionwizard.com from MiniTool. Look at this, quite interesting, because we have all the information about what is the disk benchmark, how the MiniTool Partition Wizard measured the performance of the hard drive, this is quite interesting because, well, there is a lot of very useful information, but looking from here, the kind of performance here that you should expect. This is the explanation for the following entries. According to this, this is the thing that we should expect for well, the measure for the SSD drive using 4K size and the rest of the performance test that is performed by Partition Wizard MiniTool. Wow, this is just very useful and very very nice from the MiniTool Partition Wizard team. And there is more. Right click over this partition and let me go to properties in order to verify the space that is already in use on this partition. That remember that it's a copy of the DIX number one. Okay, 16 gigs. And let's do this. Resize the partition. Let me reduce the size over here. Click OK. Apply. Yes. And we are going to have 31 gigs of unallocated space when the pending operation finish. And basically, it's finishing. Okay. Already finished. And that's it. Go here. Properties. Now, 92% occupied because we only have one gig free. And now, with the unallocated partition, we can apply the data recovery, create a partition just to run a surface test, wipe the partition, just check the properties. Well, total free space, 31 gigs. And what happens if we can want to resize again in order to recover the space? Click apply. Yes. Wow, that was fast. Properties. But from here, we can explore the content, and as you can see, everything appears to be fine. That is the H hard drive is here. H, let me check. Hello, like this. Well, don't want to here. Hello, yes, perfect. Properties. Well, according to Windows, we have 26 gigs free. So, as easy to resize the partition of unit. Let's do something else. Let's convert the current NTFS partition to a FAT partition. Let's see if that is possible. It's not quite common, but well, let's see. Appear as FAT32, but we need to apply. Let's apply. Yes. Just wait. But basically, since yep, it's possible to convert the different format of the partition. All the changes has been applied successfully. So now we have a FAT32 partition. Let's check out the properties. This is the H. Let's review the H partition over here on properties. Yep, according to the operating system, it's a FAT32 partition. Try something else. Let me right click. Let me split the partition. And now we are going to get two partitions. Click OK, apply. Yes. And it's going fast. Cool. Let's wait. It's already changed split the partition. And now we have G partition. Let's verify. Okay, G partition. 20 gigs, free space. It's still a FAT32 partition. Pretty cool. Let's see something very interesting that this change partition type ID. In this list, we can find different type of partition, like a master boot record, UEFI partition, BIOS, Intel, Sony, Lenovo, basic partition, Windows, recovery, IBM, storage space partition, interesting, or use input an ID manually. If you know the specific ID for that partition, you can easy entry manually the ID. This is, well, very useful in some situation. Of course, we have the tutorial in this link. Actually, if we select a partition and right click, we are going to see a lot of different options to start working with the partition. Also, in this menu over here, we can change the language of the user interface. Enter the license key. Check the about, visit the partitionwizard.com from MiniTool. MiniTool Partition Wizard is basically a tool that we should all have. In the meantime, I'm going to recover the original partition from the disk number 2. Many thanks to MiniTool to build another incredible tool. Many thanks to MiniTool to trust in time to videos, your channel. If you like the content of the channel, please subscribe, it's free, hit the like button and share. And remember, see you on the next video.